Hey guys, Dan here, aka Wolf, and today we're going to talk about realism in the world of The Last of Us, a celebrated video game IP that is beloved for many reasons. Its organic, fully fleshed out characters, its haunting and beautiful landscapes, its violent, gruesome, and brutal take on survival, and its grounded sense of realism compared to most video game narratives. But just how realistic is the world of The Last of Us? The shocking answer is, perhaps not as realistic as one might think, though that actually works in The Last of Us' favor, and we'll talk about that more at the end of the video. But first, I'm going to ask you, if you're jamming out to the content I produce, subscribe to me, leverage the unrivaled power of that notification bell, and leave your love in the comments. What you have to say means much and more to me than you could possibly know. Ammunition in the world of The Last of Us is treated as rare for the player, but not rare for the world. Every faction you will come across in Part 1 and Part 2 has weapons and ammo galore, and oftentimes military-grade hardware. And while this is often explained by the assumption that these groups took over Fedra military caches, both games take place over two decades since the collapse of society and the end of the manufacturing world. Even if the majority of the US ammo supply wasn't consumed in the first 5 years following the collapse, which I believe is the more likely scenario, ammo typically only lasts about a decade, and certainly not longer outside of ideal climate-controlled conditions. Whatever ammunition is left, if any, should be very unreliable and probably misfiring more often than not. And we won't even get into not having the supplies to clean weapons and keep them operating smoothly 20 to 30 years after collapse. Fascinatingly, the NPCs we encounter seem to believe that ammo is an infinite supply as well. Or so their behavior tells us. Whether it's them endlessly firing a mounted 50 cal or repeatedly executing the wounded or the restrained with gunfire instead of simply using a knife or some other means, the NPCs in this world never display a conservative mindset for this valuable and irreplaceable resource. Gasoline for generators and automobiles is another aspect of the games that is not approached realistically. Gasoline spoils very rapidly unless treated with preservatives, and even then you can only make it last so long before it eventually oxidizes. It certainly does not last decades, and while gasoline isn't depicted in The Last of Us as being ubiquitous per se, the fact that it is depicted at all in the game's timeline is at odds with basic chemistry. Petrol simply wouldn't exist anymore. That means no automobiles, no motorboats, no generators, no combustion engines would be functioning anymore, which in turn would have a cascading effect on every way that electricity is provided to communities in our wasted world, from the WLF-controlled Seattle to the remote paradise of Jackson. And I know what you're thinking. Jackson is powered by a hydroelectric dam, and while this is true, that hydroelectric dam deploys huge turbines that require petroleum-based byproducts to function properly. Manufactured clothing is another resource that would be rare, if not completely non-existent, some 25 years after a complete collapse of society. What most don't realize is, outside of climate-controlled environments, clothing deteriorates very rapidly in moisture, mold, sunlight, and a wide array of insects that love to feast on undisturbed material. My dad, who was a locksmith in the 80s and 90s, once told me of having to change the locks for the famous bar Gillies that was featured in the film Urban Cowboy. This was after 1989 when the bar closed due to the two owners having a falling out, but before it burned down a year later in 1990. The bar had been closed for some months and perhaps over a year, leaving everything sealed inside like a time capsule. Only a time capsule that wasn't a vacuum and had no climate control. I remember him describing the t-shirts in the gift shop as having rotted over their wire hangers in a gruesome and very The Last of Us fashion. But this wasn't a building that had been sealed for decades. This building had only been sealed for a year or less, demonstrating that nature is more than ready to rapidly erase all traces of us outside of our continuous maintenance and outside of climate-controlled conditions. Canned goods and packaged food items also do not last for decades, yet canned goods and candy bars are what our playable characters find in both games to restore bits of health. I love finding snack packs and old candy bars just like mankind used to make. After all, it makes such a satisfying sound. But the reality is, not only would packaged candy bars not be safe to eat 20 to 30 years after collapse, they expire pretty quickly, and even more so when not stored in a cool and dry environment. Outside of such conditions, canned goods will generally only last up to a maximum of 5 years. The persistence of child culture is another aspect of the world of The Last of Us that doesn't strike me as being realistic 25 years following the collapse of society. The invention of child culture is a relatively new development in human history. Prior to this, children were integral parts of the working family unit. Essentially, small adults more than capable of saddling and riding horses, using firearms and setting traps, animal husbandry, preparing meals, mending clothing, and performing other adult tasks, including taking jobs. Very difficult jobs. In The Last of Us, there are notes and artifacts left by children in nomadic families that reflect a contemporary take on children, such as writing a letter to Santa Claus in passive verbiage, wishing for a guard dog, or creating a child fort in an abandoned aquarium that could be infiltrated by infected or dangerous humans at any moment. Unless you are fortunate enough to live in a protected community like Jackson or a QZ, it seems unlikely that children born to nomads in this world would allow their kids to be softened or entertain the realm of fantasy. There is no time or place for it, and if you're old enough to aim and pull a trigger, it only makes sense that survivors would bring up their children to be as hard and as prepared to survive in this unforgiving world as possible. After all, your child's survival absolutely depends on it. Another charming and immersive aspect of the game is the found letters that are lying everywhere that tell us countless stories within the story about the people who lived and died in this beautiful and brutal world. And while I love these found letters, wouldn't change them, and always look forward to finding another, it's not very realistic. Not only would these letters probably not be left behind in such numbers, paper is one of the very first things that time and the elements will destroy unless perfectly preserved. But all of these things, everything mentioned in this video, is not a criticism. From the ammunition, to the gas, to the clothing, to the child culture, all of it is okay, and I wouldn't change a thing because the world of The Last of Us was never meant to be a survivor simulator. Instead of being an accurate prediction model of the post-apocalyptic remnants of mankind some 25 years later, The Last of Us provides us with something better. A lived-in world half reclaimed by nature, where the ghosts of yesterday are everywhere instead of being completely invisible to us, or worse, forgotten. The Last of Us, as presented, keeps us ever mindful of what the people in this world lost by clothing our beloved characters in its trappings, equipping them with its treasures, and rewarding us with the rare find of an old candy bar to heal ourselves or an old trading card for our wistful collection. Never mind that paper stock is one of the fastest materials to rot outside of a climate-controlled environment. 100% realism is not always a good thing when it comes to telling stories and inhabiting a world with its own tone, its own consistency, and its own rules, so long as that consistency serves to provide an iconic feeling and mood, which The Last of Us does in spades. At the end of the day, I wouldn't want to experience The Last of Us any other way than the way they gave it to us. If this video meant something to you, you can help me build something great by subscribing and leaving your love in the comments. Come talk to me on Twitch, where I stream every single day, and we are always having the fun and engaging with each other in interesting and unique ways. After all, you never know what I'm gonna come up with next. Follow me on Twitter and show me pictures of the wolf in your life. And don't forget that I have other videos that may provide you with something you didn't know that you were searching for. Until next time, I will catch you in the wilderness of the mental.
Dan, also known as Wolf.